Well, yeah, and in fact, I've argued in this country that plays into the hands of people like the Discovery Institute to try and claim it's a scientific question.
Yes, I know.
And,
yeah.
But I think that and this is probably where we both agree, and maybe it's a good time to go to the questions, unless you have something pressing you want to ask me. You wrote The Selfish Gene, and I've written my books because we find the real world so amazing that it'd be better if more people knew about it. And I guess, and part of my reason there is somewhat the same as yours, and not so much focused against incorrect beliefs, but I actually think the world would be a better place if we were willing to understand, just accept it for what it is.
Absolutely.
And without fear and without terror, and that would, if that governed public policy, just to say public policy and our life will be based on accepting the world for what it is, without preconception and fear, then the world would be a better place.
Absolutely. I can't disagree with that. My whole life has been devoted to explaining science because it's wonderful. I mean, here we are on this planet, and maybe the only planet in the universe where there is anything capable of understanding why it's there. We may be our brain may be the only object in the entire universe that has the capacity to understand, to internalize the universe in the sense of setting up a model of the universe. So it is an amazing privilege to be alive, to be capable of understanding, to be alive in the 21st century when understanding of the universe and of life is far, far greater than in any past century. We should make the most of that, and those people who are deprived of the opportunity to learn about how wonderful reality is, it's simply tragic that they should go to their grave missing out on the opportunities that an understanding of science, not the practice of science, yeah, necessarily, not Bunsen burners and things, but understanding the scientific method and understanding what an enormous amount is known, and the challenge of how much is not known.
Exactly.
And how much there is still work yet to do.
Yeah, and we give people the impression that scientists really want to, and in fact, the people use that on who are countering science all the time, they say, scientists, they just want to, they have this picture, and it's a story. First of all, that's the first thing they tell about science. It's a story. It's not a story. It's more than a story. It makes predictions, and that's vitally important. But they want to have this little bit of knowledge, and they don't want it to be attacked. When in fact, it's exactly the opposite. The thing that drives scientists forward, certainly drives me and everyone else I know, is actually the stuff we don't understand. And moreover, it's not as if we want to always agree with our colleagues, because the way you get famous is by proving them wrong. And that's what you go into work every day, is you want to prove all your colleagues wrong. And in fact, getting back to education, to me, the one thing that I hope every student has at some point in their life, and I tell this explicitly, and I think it's really profoundly important, the one experience that I hope you have in either high school or college or somewhere in your education is to have some belief that you profoundly, deeply hold proved to be wrong. Because that is the most eye-opening experience you can have, and as a scientist, to me, it's the most exciting experience I could ever have. So
I think we should switch to two questions.